We are standing on the banks of the Apalachicola River today, along one of probably the most famous geological exposures in all the state, and it's called Alum Bluff. There are a number of ways that you can get to this beautiful place. One is by boat. You can put in on the Apalachicola River at Bristol. There are boat landings in both Bristol and Bluntstown, and you come upriver until you get to Alum Bluff. Or you can put in on any number of boat ramps that are between here and Chattahoochee. So you can either do it by motorboat, or you can do it by kayak or canoe, or float down here if you are so inclined. There's another way. There's an approach by land, and you actually come through a beautiful preserve that's owned by the Nature Conservancy, and it's called the Apalachicola Bluffs and Ravines. One of the most impressive things that you'll see here at Alum Bluff is the elevation change. You see a great big exposure of geological strata. And in Florida, that's not something that we usually get to see. We don't have any mountains in Florida. We don't have any giant canyons. However, along some rivers, like this one, the Apalachicola, it has meandered back and forth in its floodplain, and it has cut into the geologic strata that are exposed here. So what you will see are a number of different geologic units of differing ages. The oldest one at the base is around 18 million years old. They're full of fossil shell materials and vertebrates and shark's teeth. So people who are enthused about hunting fossils can come here, have a great time. You can come here and experience being on Florida's largest river by volume, the Apalachicola River. So if you're a canoe, kayak enthusiast, this is a great place to come. And if you would like to come and see plants and animals that are unique to this region, this is a great place to do it because there are a number of rare plants and animals that exist only here and nowhere else in the entire state of Florida. So there's a little bit of something for every nature enthusiast here. There are very few places left in indeed the country and probably the world where you can go and not necessarily hear the influence of man. Planes, highways, all of that. Here on the Apalachicola River in some spots, you can actually get away from all that and you can simply immerse yourself in the sounds of nature, like the gurgling of a creek running down through a ravine, or even a waterfall. That's something important. People need to have the ability to get out and get away from all the sights and sounds of humanity and get into nature. And this is a place you can do that still in Florida. Mm-hmm.